And press briefing, it might well turn into a positive addition here in Chicago. Actually, I think we hope that you just didn't show up because they bumped you off the flight and canceled your flight last night and you didn't have anywhere else to go. But you are really interested in learning what we want to share with you this morning, because we have some exciting news. And in fact, we are very proud to help celebrate the 100th anniversary of an auto show that is very important in the North American market by launching our latest SUV, the Porsche Cayenne GTS, to the American public. You may remember that last year, at the same time, at the same place, we showed you what we then felt was the pinnacle of sports car engineering, of racing high technology, our Porsche RS Spyder. The Porsche RS Spyder once again cast us immediately into the role of the underdog, of the well-proven task of being the giant killer. And now, a year later, maybe we should look how the motorsport season fared last year. Just let's see for yourself.
Significantly increased our efficiency.
We
made a great qualifying. I think the laps turned in by both cars. The track was faster. We learned a lot from last year. But, you know, we're here to win the race.
Just amazing. So really happy to get the outright. Thanks to Paul, Penske, everyone involved. You know, Sashi did a great job today. It's just really good. They got us right up behind the 7 car, and we run with them the whole time until I was lucky enough to get by them in the end. So it's a great team effort by everyone.
Yeah, it was a great race. Good battle between both cars and team, and it was good. We win again overall. That's really nice for Porsche. Again, one overall victory.
Right now, we're leading the championship, and this is a very challenging track coming into Road America.
People were going crazy because they really enjoyed the race and that's what they wanted to see, close racing.
And I would say many of those races have been won on strategy, and I think it gives the crews the opportunity to show their strengths also.
The car was so great this year. Penske again, all the time the quickest on tire change. I mean, it's difficult to imagine that we can lose with all this package.
To gain one or two tenths on a lap, we are on the maximum of our possibility. But to lose 2 or 3 seconds by lap because of traffic is very difficult to accept. So you have all the time to find the best solution with the traffic to lose the minimum of time, but few times I can tell you it's very, very hot inside the car.
Until the end of the race,
Romain
did a perfect move, and I'm so happy.
It was perfect. I think it will be a big moment on my memory of possible in a great move for the race here in America.
We get an overall victory, cannot believe it.
You see this year the reliability was very good. Like 2 weeks ago in Atlanta, we had not a single problem for the whole 10 hours.
I pushed very hard for more than 2 hours. We are champion. I mean, it's a dream for me.
Perfect.
I mean, I think I need one night to sleep about it to really realize it.
The cars have been fantastic all the time. And great getting these overall victories and fast wins. It's been a lot of fun.
I'm really happy about the race. Again, we won the class.
Great. When you see you can win one more and more, and then in the end it happened like this, and it's a dream.
It's had a Cinderella story season this year.
Very satisfying. Started out a little rough, but in the end it was perfect.
In the championship, braking, turning ability, it's amazing for us drivers. It's always a pleasure every time we approach a point.
I love the series because it's a thinking man series and also one that needs reliability and certainly the best drivers.
Overall, I would say it has been a great show for the fans, and besides the success in winning championships, that's the most important why we are here for.
Now, how was that for the season? 8 out of 12 overall victories against a much more established and, what's more important, an even more powerful competition. Some of these LMP1 guys, namely Audi, had more than 200 horsepower against our little R Spider. But we came out all right. And I'm proud to say that aside from 11 class victories out of these 12 races, there wasn't one single Porsche Penske race car that did not finish, and they all made it onto the winner's podium. But what I personally find most amazing is the fact that the RS Spider was designed from a clean sheet after an 8 years absence from motorsport, and you all know what 8 years mean in the fast-paced development time of motorsport. But even more amazing was the fact that this RS Spider was conceived and developed by a bunch of young Porsche engineers who had never seen action before. And they still were able to continue the tradition of establishing Porsche firmly in the winner's circle. Speaking of young engineers, it is interesting to note that about the same time when the Chicago was busy trying to get their very first auto show on the road, across the Atlantic, at the Salon de l'Automobile in Paris, France, a young engineer named Ferdinand Porsche was introducing a groundbreaking vehicle, the very first gas electric hybrid car, a car that your French colleagues hailed at that time the greatest invention of the age. And it is in this spirit of innovation and the tradition of engineering excellence that runs through the veins of every single Porsche up to this very day. You might call it a Porsche DNA. But we are not only rich in tradition, I think we have a pretty bright future. So 2007 was not only a good year on the racetrack, it was also a really exciting year off the racetrack in the North American marketplace. And who better to review our performance in 2007 than Peter Schwarzenbauer, the president and CEO of Porsche Cars North America. Peter?
Yes, thank you, Bernd. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. And I would like to start out by saying, normally I am not a superstitious person. But looking back 12 months ago, where we launched the RS Spyder here in Chicago in the same room, and if you have seen our video and the success of this car, we started to think back in Atlanta, isn't there something in this Chicago auto show, a certain spirit which might help us also by launching another car? And this is the main reason why we decided to come here today and launch the new Cayenne GTS at the Chicago Auto Show. On a more serious note, why is Chicago so important to us? You can see here on the chart now, meanwhile, Chicago is the fifth largest market for Porsche in the US. And not only is it important from a volume point of view, it's also, we have a corporate leg here. A Porsche subsidiary, Porsche Financial Services, is headquartered here in Chicago, and we recently appointed our new lead agency, Kramer Kressel, which is also headquartered in downtown Chicago. So you can see there's a lot of link between Porsche and the Chicago area. Now you could ask, why did you choose an SUV? And maybe the best answer is on the next chart. You can see here on the left-hand side a pie chart showing Porsche sales in North America. And you can see here that roughly a third is Cayenne sales and about two-thirds are sports cars. If you have a deeper look now into the Chicago area, you can see here that in Chicago we have 50% of our Porsche sales are Cayennes and roughly 50% sports cars. So we are over proportionally strong with the SUV in this market. That means this is another reason why we decided to bring this car here and to launch it in this area. We also recently restructured our entire field organization, and we added what we call here, you can see it on this map, a central region. We had three areas in the past, now we have four, and this central region goes from North Dakota down to Kansas and over to Ohio. And the regional office is also headquartered here in Chicago. So you see many, many reasons why we are here today and why we think that Chicago is an extremely important marketplace for Porsche. Now, I would like to review briefly with you 2007, as Bernd mentioned. We were not only very successful on the racetrack, we had also a very rewarding year across the US in all our showrooms. We posted in 2007 another historic record for Porsche. We sold over 34,000 cars. And this 34,000 cars, you have to put in perspective. On one hand, the environment we operated in wasn't very favorable for the automotive industry. And on the other hand, you should never forget when you talk about 34,000 cars that our entry model has an MSRP above $40,000. By the way, this new record in 2007 means that this was the fourth consecutive record year in the Porsche history. So we are doing extremely well in this market. We are very, very happy of how we are performing here. I would not like to bore you now with too many numbers, but I would like to point out one thing here regarding the performance of our 911 range in 2007. Because this, I think, is something really outstanding. We sold over 13,000 911 in 1 year. We never have done this before. This is an absolute new record. And you also have to see, out of this 13,000, 3,000 of them have been our absolute top model. That means a 911 Turbo Coupe and cab. Really quite an accomplishment. Another car line which contributed heavily to this success was the newly launched Cayenne. Despite the fact that we didn't have a car available in the market for the entire year, we launched the car in March 2007. Despite this fact, we managed to increase the volume by 20% in 2007 compared to the previous year, 2006. Huge success for the second generation of Cayenne. This second generation in Cayenne was a great engineering challenge. The reason was because we basically, from the markets, pushed our engineers into the direction, said, look guys, we need more power, because at the end of the day, we are selling Porsches. But, of course, we have to be extremely careful and look into the subject, how can we improve fuel economy? So we were asking for more power, but less fuel economy, which is physically not always easy to do. But I think it's safe to say that our engineers delivered. When we launched the Cayenne, we managed to get more power, more performance, but at the same time, less consumption. To be precise, we reduced the fuel economy by about 15% in this new Cayenne range. So I think this was a huge achievement from our engineering colleagues back in Weissach. Talking about fuel consumption, we also announced last year that we are developing a hybrid which will be available in the Cayenne. And here I can tell you that the target we set our engineers is a further reduction of 30%. 30%, we are telling our engineers they have to reduce the fuel consumption when we launch this hybrid model. But, and this is the difficult part, at the same time, retain the typical Porsche performance characteristics. I have seen the car, I have driven a prototype, and I can tell you, I'm extremely confident that our engineers will deliver as always. Let me jump to one very interesting topic, Trans-Siberia Rally. Some of my colleagues within Porsche Cars North America are always telling me this is my private hobby. And it might be a little bit, but it has also some professional background. When we launched the Cayenne back in 2003, we had several camps out there. You participate also in this discussion, of course. We had some people saying, you know, Porsche is totally crazy launching an SUV. And then we had some other groups saying, yeah, you know, maybe we are capable of launching an SUV which is good on-road, but they have no experience, no capabilities on the off-road side. And we challenged this and we said, no, you will see that this car will be the best on-road, but it will be also extremely good off-road. So what we did last year is, we basically took a stock Cayenne S, added some special equipment, and entered it in this grueling 4,400 miles rally marathon from Moscow to Mongolia. And not only did we finish it, the team we entered, the team of Porsche Cars North America, with the veteran Rod Millen on the wheel, finished first, took the overall victory. So I think this means it's safe to say off-road capabilities, tick, we proved it. Today we are here to launch the new Cayenne GTS. And the Cayenne GTS will set a new benchmark when it comes to on-road performance. This car has the typical Porsche DNA as standard. It doesn't come as an option. It is included in the car as it is in all our 911s, RS Spiders, and all the cars we ever have built. I could explain you now with a thousand words what this Porsche DNA exactly means, but I would like to show you our new TV commercial, which I think can explain it much better than I can do. This TV spot was produced to salute the arrival of the Cayenne GTS, and it's called The Call of the Wild. Let's have a look. So you can see the Cayenne GTS has all the Porsche genetics. But now I think it's time to present you the car and to explain a little bit more of the details about this product. And for this reason, I would like to introduce one of my colleagues, David Pryor, Vice President of Marketing of Porsche Cars North America, and by the way, the only native American speaker today.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Cayenne GTS is the best handling SUV in the world, period. A bold statement, an easy claim for a marketing guy to make, but I'm absolutely confident it's true. When the engineers set out to create this newest addition to the Cayenne model range, they wanted to impart all of the sports car handling characteristics that our drivers have come to demand, as well as the luxury and functionality that our passengers have come to expect in the Cayenne. Over 8 years ago, when the Cayenne was first on the drawing boards, the task given to our engineers was quite simple. Develop the best SUV for on-road performance that you possibly can. Of course, if you know our engineers, they're an overachieving group, and they couldn't settle for being number one just in on-road performance. They also had to be number one in off-road performance. And I think you saw the success of that in our win in the 2007 Trans-Siberia. But regarding on-road, I think we can look at something else. And I'm proud to announce that just last week, the 200,000th Cayenne rolled off the assembly line in Leipzig. 200,000 Cayennes in just 5 years. Not bad for that little sports car manufacturer from Stuttgart. But of course, our competition hasn't rested either. And they've attacked our position of on-road leadership. They've been eating away at that. So now is the perfect time for us to bring a vehicle like the GTS to the market to reestablish the on-road benchmark in the SUV segment. So let's talk a little bit about what separates the GTS from its competition in this crowded segment. Beginning with the engine, the heart of any Porsche. Our engineers started with the 4.8-liter direct fuel injection V8 from the Cayenne S. They changed the intake, they changed the control units, and the result is 405 horsepower, a healthy 20 horsepower increase over the Cayenne S, and what that results in is a 0 to 60 time of less than 6 seconds. Less than 6 seconds for a normally aspirated SUV. Quite an achievement, I think. Helping to put that power to the ground is a first for Porsche in North America, and a first in the segment, a 6-speed manual transmission in a V8 SUV. And regardless of whether the customers choose a 6-speed manual or a 6-speed Tiptronic, either version comes with a shortened final drive ratio for even sharper response. Of course, with all this additional power and performance, we have to be able to control it. So in terms of suspension, the Cayenne GTS has a specific sport-tuned suspension. Air suspension is standard, approximately 20 millimeters lower than a normal Cayenne. Also standard is Porsche Active Suspension Management. This gives the driver complete control and a range of 3 different settings, from comfort all the way to sport, so they can control the driving dynamics of this vehicle. All of this performance is easily accessible via one simple button on the center console, aptly labeled Sport. One push of this button, the throttle response sharpens, the suspension goes into its most dynamic performance mode, and the sport exhaust opens up for a driving experience you can feel as well as hear. Turning to styling, all of this additional performance, I think it's only fitting that the GTS inherits the front fascia from the Cayenne Turbo. Also standard on this vehicle is an aero package, including the lower trims, the body color lower trims you see on the front, side, and lower rear, plus a distinctive dual-plane spoiler on the top area of the tailgate. Also standard on the Cayenne GTS are 21-inch wheels with high-performance tires. These not only increase the agility, but they also provide that best-in-class braking that our customers have come to expect in a Porsche. We, of course, couldn't leave the interior alone either. The GTS comes standard with the sport seats for both driver and co-pilot. Alcantara centers more deeper side bolsters for enhanced control during dynamic driving. But we also didn't want to leave out the rear passengers. And there are sport seats in the rear of the GTS as well, because we firmly believe you're never too old or too young to enjoy the Porsche driving experience. Further differentiating the GTS are the colors. The Nordic Gold you see here and the GTS Red that you see on the screen, both of these colors are exclusive to the Cayenne GTS. Following its North American debut here today at the Chicago Auto Show, the GTS will be available at U.S. dealerships starting immediately from an MSRP of $69,300. I hope you'll agree that the Cayenne GTS will be the new benchmark in on-road performance. We've imparted all of those beloved characteristics from our sports cars into the GTS, and we can say, as we do with every Porsche, there is no substitute. Baron, Peter?
Thank you, David. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we naturally have a lot more information, lots of pictures and all the technical information and technical data in the press kit CD that we provide on the way out. But before we do that, a Porsche press briefing wouldn't be a Porsche press briefing without giving you the opportunity to ask questions. To ask questions on the GTS or on any Porsche-related subject. Before you raise your hand, please identify yourself, not with your ID number, but just so we can understand the question. And we have these product specialists over here and there with their microphones for better communications.
My name is Bob Brooks, Auto Tech News. I'm interested in Porsche's affiliation with VW to get a lower average CO2. Is that affiliation going forward? Where does it stand?
I mean, this whole Volkswagen issue, of course, we are working more together with the Volkswagen Group on all kinds of technology. The CO2 reduction is only one area where we are cooperating, and it's too soon to give you too many details, but we are working on many different technology areas together with the group.
Can I add something to this as a typical PR guy? Yeah. A lot of people think that one of the underlying reasons why this cooperation and this association was taking place is the fact that we might sneak into compensating our comparatively high fuel consumption with the VW Polos and so forth. But that's not so. One of the main reasons why this association will work is that it vastly increases our potential for development, as Peter said, purchasing synergies that we, as even a premier, but rather small niche player, won't be able to do on our own. Is there any other questions, please?
Yeah. Hi, Deanne Durbin with the Associated Press. There seems to be some indication that the U.S. economic problems are trickling up to the highest income buyers. I'm just wondering where you see luxury sales going in 2008, if they're going to be down along with the rest of the market.
Yes, I agree with you. I think in the last 2-3 months we have seen some effects in the luxury segment as well. So we are forecasting 2008 that also the luxury segment will be down compared to what we have seen in 2007. Now, I can't give you an exact number, to be honest, because we are currently forecasting what we call internally a mild recession. If it's a mild recession, we don't see a huge impact on our forecast. If we have something deeper, then we have to talk again. We have one question.
Gary Woodsenberg,
AutoMedia.com. Is this an 08 or an 09 model?
This is an 08 model.
Don't tell me we were so exhausted.
Late night last.
Okay, one question over here.
Jim McGraw from Popular Mechanics Magazine. When are you going to step up to ALMS LMP1?
I mean, if you have seen the results last season, why would we do it? We won 8 out of 12 races with a smaller car, so there's currently no reason of doing it.
Okay, if there are no further questions. Was there one over there? No. We really are grateful and thankful for your interest that you made it through the slush and the snow here this morning. Do come and have a closer look at the GDS either up here or at our stand, where, by the way, we have a lot more beautiful Porsche models, and we also make a pretty mean cappuccino. Thanks again, and goodbye.
Thank you.